Sometimes it's hard to imagine. Yeah, it's hard for me to relate. 'Cause I never held you in my arms. Well, maybe it's not too late to try. And I don't fight the rest. I use the rest. It does apply to everyone. In Africa, when I go, I spend most of my time getting African musicians to embrace this really rich cultural heritage, and the options they have musically are great, but they're spending so much energy trying to be what they see on television or what already exists and what they view as successful, as opposed to recreating their own brand, which would be successful as well, you know. Like, take a country like Jamaica. Everyone in the world knows Jamaican music. Very small country, you know, but everyone is familiar with, you know. And I think most cultures have the opportunity to do this, to make their own style, their own brand, their own unique take on it because of their own unique folkloric history. Mm-hmm. So I do spend a lot of time trying to empower people to inspire them to.
Toho čekala, že zažiju nějaký autentický zážitek, že se dozvím něco nového o přístupu k hudbě a vůbec k tomu, jak se učí hudba.
I don't have a lot of children. I don't have any legacy, in a sense. I have records and things like that. But in this time of my life, I really want to inspire new artists to continue the excellence of the craft and the beauty of the art that inspired me. And we can't only just do this for the money. We have to find a way to make the industry better, you know, to make the art better, because it's dying. You know, there are computer games, there's more movies, there's all these other options of things that people are less and less interested in music, you know, because there's no connection anymore. People feel like they're only being sold a product and that there's not so often honest connection. So I think we need to really take responsibility as artists to, no. It has to feel good. I would rather, like we say, you know, 150 people that really get it and feel the importance of this and not only value a big stadium where no one really cares. They're just there because it's the event or the big party or something to do. But to get that real human connection with our art is magical when it happens. And I think that sometimes we forget about it and focus on the financial business part of it. In the beginning, it was like, oh, I have to sell more, I have to do these things, I have to, you know, find a way to, you know, to be a bigger artist. And then my focus changed to like, ooh, I should enjoy being unique. I should enjoy being the gourmet restaurant. I should enjoy these things and not fight them so much. So once I made this choice to redefine what success was. Success is really having a great exchange, you know, of conversation or music or an emotional exchange. This is success. It's not that I had 2,000 people playing pool and talking and not really connecting. This is really not success for me. Mm-hmm. Financially, maybe there is some, we get paid a lot, but if I'm feeling empty at the end of the concert, then I feel like it was a failure. Mm-hmm. Yes, you know, so once I did redefine what a successful performance is, mm-hmm. it changed everything for me. And then I didn't have to try to be these other things. I only had to do the best I could with what I could control, which mm-hmm. is the actual art, the actual performance, the actual channeling of the experiences mm-hmm. and energy through and from my heart, you know, into touching people. You know, mm-hmm. if I can make someone cry, oh, this is a great honor. You know, if you make someone laugh, it's a great honor. These mm-hmm. these small things will do. Really connect with someone and have a lifelong effect on someone where they, I heard your song and then I asked my wife to marry me because I was affected and inspired, you know. These things are real.
This happened to you with somebody?
Oh, yeah. That's beautiful. Yeah, so these things, when those things happen to you, it's like, wow. When someone says, I'm a musician now because I heard you when I was 8 years old, you know, that is, really, thank you.
Oh yeah, yeah, you do, oh yeah, you do, all that you do, oh yes, you do,
protože Wings se znám už dlouho, jak už s kapelou jako Jungle Funk, nebo potom, co dělá i samostatně solový projekty, takže jsem věděl, že to určitě bude zajímavý, což se mi splnilo dnes. Já jsem si snažil i zapisovat nějaký takové nejzajímavější věci, které mi třeba napadly jenom na základě toho, co Wings jako říkal. A pro mě to bylo celkově hodně inspirující, hlavně kladl důraz na to, jako, když řeknu sebedůvěra, tak je to takový trošku jakoby, možná ne úplně přesný, ale na to vykašlat se na to, co si o tom myslí lidi a dělat si to, co si o tom myslím já, co je pro mě dobrý. Já moderuju na Rádiu 1 a ještě vlastně dělám pořád pro Český rozhlas Jazz, teďka od Jara a určitě to zapojím asi do svých hudebních jakoby, projektů nebo hudebních představ.
It was very easy to stay humble, and I approach it like a language. So if I can speak the language, I'm not the only one that can speak the language. So there's no reason to not be humble. It's not so special, you know. It's an honor for me just to be able to share, you know, something that is so important. To me, you know, my heart, my emotions, my talent, this is a gift that they give me to allow me the opportunity to do what I love. So there's no reason to not be humble. You know, it just doesn't make sense. Thank you.
Studuju zpěv na vyšší odborné škole, Jaroslava Ježka vlastně na konzervatoři a beru to jako takovou platformu, kde člověk dostane nějaký informace, podněty a může se skrz to dostat k jazzu. Díky té škole jsem si uvědomila, že je obrovská škála, kam se můžu ještě posunovat a měli jsme tam vlastně plakát o Wingsovi, tak jsem si říkala, tyjo, proč ne, zkusím to, vím, že Wings učí na Berklee, takže mi to přišlo zajímavý, že se člověk setká s tím zahraničním přístupem. Já teďka jsem začala i dělat jako sama workshopy, takový hlasový dílny, takže to bylo pro mě inspirativní pár věcí, jako práce s těma obrazama, práce s příběhem, tak určitě něco z toho bych využila na těch dílnách, co dělám. A asi i se mi líbil ten přístup k té improvizaci, prostě neřešit nějak ty tóny, ale spíš jako sedět třeba doma, podívat se z okna a něco zaspívat a prostě pozorovat ten zvuk.
She told about the workshop and we said, wow, that's very nice, we're going. And then we said, where is it? She said, it's in Prague.
Yes.
Okay, go to Prague.
So we said, if Prague is not coming to us, we go to Prague, uh-huh. Right?
You can learn something
teach
within yourself to express and to do things with your voice you're not normally...
Sing from the soul, from the heart. Okay. It's easier than I thought. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And sing your own, search your own voice. Eh? Mm-hmm. Sing your own voice.
Yeah.
That's
don't have manners.
I think that was the main thing.
Darling, you are you to me. Honest, you do. Yeah, you do. At first I thought it was an infatuation. This feeling that I had for so long. And now I find myself just wanting you, wanting to marry you and take me home. I know that.
Which one is a special experience with my voice? Well, maybe with when I was touring with Sting. No one knew me. They didn't know my songs. They didn't know me. They were only wanting to hear Sting. And I came on stage and it's not Sting yet. So people would stand up and start walking to the toilet and to get concessions and food, right? The power to be able to stand there alone and sing and make everyone stop. And this loud room goes to quiet, to hear every breath, every note, every nuance. This is a great, great honor to me to hear, to see these people react. You know, with unspoken, you know, we're connected. This is a great feeling.
Time I ask myself, boom, 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 you know, so I can keep both parts. What it is I'm doing, boom, boom, who it is I'm searching for, boom, boom, we all. Am I winning or losing? Yeah.